So on January 31st, we're going to have something called a super blue blood moon. Now, there's a lot of things going on in that. We've got a super moon, which means the moon's at its closest point to the Earth. It's going to be a blue moon, so it's the second full moon for the month. It only happens every 2.5 years. And it's going to be a blood moon, which is a total lunar eclipse. So the moon's going to go behind the Earth in its shadow, and we're going to get, it projects a red colour onto the moon.
The light's going through the Earth's atmosphere. It's taking away all the blue light, it's taking away the green light, and you're left with that red, that orange is, and that's being cast onto the face of the moon. It's almost like all the sunsets, all the sunrises are being projected onto the face of the moon.
So a lunar eclipse only happens during a full moon because full moons only happen when the moon is on the opposite side of the Earth to the sun. So if you're standing on the moon, the Earth appears about 4 times bigger from the moon than the moon appears to us on Earth.
We're actually here in Australia in the best seats possible for this viewing, especially here in Western Australia. What you really want is when the moon is low on the horizon, so around 6 p.m, 7 p.m. Because what's happening is you're seeing an optical illusion where the trees, the buildings around make it look much larger than it actually is, and it creates some really amazing shots. The full moon causes lunacy, in fact. No, I don't think people are going to be turning into werewolves this time for the blood moon.
So people should go see this super blue blood moon because it hasn't happened in 150 years and it's a once in a lifetime event.